Jesus, 1, 2, 3.
Jesus, Jesus, Jesus.
3 cheers to Jesus, 1, 2, 3.
Jesus,
Jesus, Jesus. Kita mga nakalulay mo niya, alam tamo, kita mga Britannia, 1, 2, 3. Holy Spirit, in Jesus' name. Bago tale, ruwa tolu. Holy Spirit, we welcome you in Jesus' name. You can take your seat. Make sure you also welcome your friends, your neighbors sitting next to you this afternoon.
Nanuma mo lululuwe ko na numi tokani and dambe toka Samuel na kabri sigdinai.
It's so wonderful to be here in the Foshoa, in this side of Witilewu this afternoon.
Dora katalei menda mai sokalo na Foshoa.
We left Nandobu Park in Lautoka at 11:30 at midday on coming down on the Queen's Road to come here.
We mama ni tinigandua na singalebu biu mai kina Nandobu Park mai Lautoka. We kito muria mai na Queen's Road me kito yava mai kene kami niku.
I believe the crowd here is about double the crowd that we had in Lautoka at Nandobu Park. We were really blessed with the people. With the NCF on the western side, so there are so many people.
Obo mbota bi kenda na wili wili nda tigo nikuwa ebi abaga ruwa taki. Kenda wili wili na soko soko lote, ratiko mai na esa sabara ka kima misa kalowina kandina na tigo eni maika ena singalewa nikuwa.
The church start at 8 o'clock and finish nearly at midday today, at about 11:45 or 11:50.
Te huna lotu na wala kaloko onge mei dhabatiko.
I was blessed to be part of the church service in Lautoka. I always enjoy being in the presence of God. Hallelujah. I remember Lautoka started way back, around about in 2005, with two Form 5 girls from Jasper William High School.
Lautoka tegbunga na Ronondo Lukalima na Ronongo Nelewa rawa bulitiko na Cornibuli Jasper William School.
One is my daughter Ophia and one is Leilani Tale, which is Leilani, Mrs. Leilani Mundurdin Taltala today.
Ronongo Nelewa ya sai ko Pastor Ophia batake Rendin Taltanga se Leilani Mundu and singabila ni ko.
This is what God can do when you say yes. God is not looking at your situation. He's just looking for a platform for God to perform miracles. When you avail yourself, then God will perform miracle in your life. Hallelujah. And I believe that a lot of people here that you experience what God is doing in your life. Even though most of the time that we are not faithful, but God remains faithful because he cannot lie to himself. Hallelujah. I fail so much in the eyes of God. But this God never failed me once. Not never failed me. Never. Never. After 17 years as a Taltala, and after 8 years as a Dobu now in the Lotu Ezele, so the 8 plus 17, never once this God failed me. That's how wonderful the God that we are serving today. So when you face with this situation, remember, pick up the pins and move on. When people fail you, it's not the end of the book, it's just the end of a chapter. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Because this God is so faithful. And last week I was talking about the condition that call the presence of Holy Spirit in our life. Hallelujah. You want the Holy Spirit? Jesus said, it is good for you for me to go. What does that mean? Because if I go, then the Holy Spirit will come. The Holy Spirit does not have any body. Jesus has a body. So Jesus will be limited by the body. The Holy Spirit is not limited by anybody. When we were at Nandobu Park, the Holy Spirit was with us. And the Holy Spirit was with you when you are in your home. When you are waiting here, we passed through Silatoka. The Holy Spirit was in here, in Delenabesi, in Ndonumai, in Lami, in Wisari, in Namboro, in Wainandoi. All along the road, the Holy Spirit was there. Even when we are crossing over the Melrose Bridge in Sigatoka. Hallelujah, that's a good one. He's there, yara yara. Ever presence. So Jesus was telling the disciple, don't worry. It's good for you for me to go. Because when I go, I'll ask the Father for the Holy Spirit to come. You open the fridge. You open the cupboard. You check your bank account. And nothing there. As long as you have the Holy Spirit. Because he's your friend. Hallelujah. Ask your neighbor, who is your best friend? I don't worry about my tomorrow because my Holy Spirit has been through my tomorrow. We were having a church in Matintar. The total member of New Methodist on the western side, about 28. And this Kaltala from the AOG in Brisbane said, I can see that the youth of this church will grow to thousands.
We prophesy in Doni Kaltala, and one of my nights, so to na AOG, a tunoka, we run a tamangon, erna, Syria, and Undon.
They will march through towns and cities proclaiming my name. Standing there with a total congregation of about 20 to 25, hearing this. Hallelujah. How come? When only 20 of us there. When you will drive past a village, people will say, souls to Jesus. They have to stop and pray. I never thought of a television. Hallelujah. And people will stop me on the road and said, Taltala, Rendona Masu. I recall that Sunday when I look around, I saw my wife, my children, and Taltala Gaste, very, very young, just a young youth. Taltala Tauri. How can you believe that? How can you explain that? Amen. Hallelujah. This church will be like a lava from coming out from the mountain. And wherever they go, they'll put fire into people's life.
Hallelujah.
And sometimes you're hearing this kind of prophecy, not once, not twice, not three times, four times, so many times. Whenever this Pastor Grace Washington from a different denomination will come to Fiji, will always come to our church and giving this prophecy. Sometimes I look around and say,
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. You know, sometimes when God speaks to you, the Holy Spirit will make sure it will happen. Hallelujah. I never saw that the Grimit Center will be so full yesterday for Tal Talangase and Randi Tal Talangase, Associate Pastor and Pastor. Some churches in the West, they can't even fill half, but this is the leaders. It's a leaders training and we make it full. And today at Nandobu Park, there were crowd there.
So isso que somos outro é nem remandanga me remava Messina e vim mamã na Girmitenta e era tinha aqui na hora na viluta aqui nico andora cara que na Sinai na rara me não dou para.
So when the Holy Spirit speaks to you, you must believe.
Não na voz que não me quer dar na alta mão não dou me dar o bambuta.
Hallelujah. I was sharing in Lautoka today in my workplace before I resigned. Hallelujah. Nindabo tundo na Jumbo Boeing 747. That's about 200 million, the cost of that equipment. And God blessed me to be operation manager. This 200 million equipment is on my decision. If there's a weather in Auckland or in Sydney, I have to make a decision to go or to wait. And then at that time, I asked God to give me the wisdom. And God answered me. So God proved to me in my workplace before I resigned. If God can look after the million equipment, so many that I operate with every day, how much more that God can look after a congregation like this?
Yes, around Yalondina, Kalongo, Kina, Wanga Mugalele, where the what run around a million and the Kenisa Wendua, and the what out to one and on the Gasile, Nabatulua, and the Kena, Batulua Tagna, Namisini Lebungo.
So when I'm telling you that this God is real, I mean what I say, and I say what I mean. Not only because I read in the Bible, no, I went through with him in the weather like this, especially a cyclone time, coming up in October, right up to March. That's when I see the mighty hands of God move. And I normally teach the mission. I said, we are the Acts chapter 50, we are the Acts chapter 60, we are the continuation of the book of Acts or the book of action.
The one day they ran one and the colotu and on the gaslevu.
So God can do miracles in your life right now where you're sitting. Don't worry how God will do it. He will do it. Because he can do what only he can do. How to change water into wine, only him can do it. How to build a highway in the middle of the sea, only him can do it. How to feed the 3 billion people for 40 years, only him can do how he can do. How can their shoes grow with their feet for 40 years? Only God can do that. Turn to your neighbor, tell your neighbor, only God can do what he can do. So when you're facing something that you cannot do, hey, relax, my friend. Because God wants to take over the driving seat. Whenever you face with a problem, that means God wants to take over. When you are stuck, don't hold on to that will.
Get off the wheel.
He wants to hold the wheel. He allow you to go that far. Because come this far, he'll take over from here and then on. High five to your neighbor. Tell your neighbor, get off the wheel. Hallelujah. Am I talking to someone this afternoon? When we walk with God, there are times of issues, there are times of barriers, there are times of impossibility. You know that's God's time in your life. Jesus, in Mark chapter 4, Jesus said to this disciple, let's go to the other side. Let's go to the other side. So when they were going to the other side, Jesus go to the back of the boat, lie down with a pillow, and he was snoring away. Everything was okay. The weather was good. The wave was calm. In the middle of the meal. In the middle of the ocean, in the middle of the night. Then something happened to their life. Because Jesus wants to remind them, I have to stand up and continue from here. So when you are in the middle of your middle. Oh, hallelujah. God will take you to the middle of your middle because he wants to show you that he is God. Praise the Lord. Isn't that wonderful? But most of us, we don't want to that middle of the middle. Because sometimes we are so afraid and the spirit of fear is controlling us. But God wants us to go to the middle of the middle so he can take over from our life. That's the beauty of walking with God. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Are you with me? Okay, let's go to the lesson. Hallelujah. This is the condition that called the arrival of the Holy Spirit. We'll go to Acts chapter 1. We'll start from verse 1, verse 2, verse 3. Let's ask the Bible readers to read to us. Verse 1, verse 2, and verse 3.
Se o filho, a bola, na bola liu, que na cagadena sabateu, me da cava, cavoca, bubulita com o tissu, calou na sina, sacou daqui na cocoé, missa todo o tio nelo tambu. Não é para o ver nem a pistola. Coira candita com coia. Casa para a coia. Tela a beira. Casa levo naquele bandirindina. Nisambula tela mãe não mate. Canisando rei. Beira cambongo e passa a bula. Caboça está na beca. Nimate em tunicano.
Aleluia. Jesus allow you to walk with him. So you have the patience. Walking with him, seeing what he does, and experiencing the miracle signs and wonders of what his ministry is all about. Hallelujah. Say with me, patience. Walking with God is all about patience. Hallelujah. You know, most of the time we come to God. We just want God to answer our prayer immediately. When Jesus said, go and wait in the upper room. After one day, after 2 days, after 3 days, after 1 week, the second week, the third week, they still wait. The Holy Spirit comes when you can prove that you have the patience to wait. A lot of people, they turn back into the world because they don't have the patience to wait in God. Hallelujah. Ask your neighbor how many years you've been waiting. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Walking with God, Holy Spirit will operate in your life when you have the patience to wait. The Bible says, go and wait. Go and wait. He said the Holy Spirit will come. He did not give a time. Maybe if he say, okay, 50 days, some people will go home, go to their places, they wait for 2 days before the arrival, then they come back. If Jesus said, okay, I'll give you 50 years to live, when you're 51, you will die. Hallelujah. So you go to the world, you drink the ocean, you smoke. Hallelujah. When you know that you are 50, then you come and prepare yourself, your life to go. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. That's why God will hide to you the date that will come and call you. The Bible says that death will come to you like a thief at night. So for you and for me to get ready every day. Every day you wait on the Lord. The Bible says those that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. Hallelujah. So when God talks about wait, he's not talking about sleeping or kokoto or momo. He's talking about praying. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. When God talks about wait, he's talking about praying. Go and wait in the upper room. He's talking about praying and praying and praying and praying. We only talk about Friday night, 6 p.m. to 6 a.m.
Kena na umita lota nga, mbonga ni marombuka, may na ono na kami, kina ono na matak.
But Jesus told them, go and wait.
Ya Jesus, tu ni bertong tisipel, ndo lang ndo lewawa.
There was no break of time.
E sinindo na ngauna, tu ni bertong.
That's why when he spoke to the 500, only 120 left.
Ya nabuna, ngona, kaki ni bertong na liman rao bertong lako, ndo lang rao rosa ngabul nga, tu lewawa.
Praise the Lord. Am I talking to you? Hallelujah. You know, most of the time we come to church, we look good. Turn to your neighbor, tell your neighbor, you look good. But this is not the front line of fighting the devil. This is where it's like a gym. We come and exercise. We build up our muscle. We run on the milkshed here. We go into vigorous training here. Because the real deal is out there. So you are coming to church to build up your spiritual life. But the battlefield is your workplace, your relatives, the Facebook. Okay, while we still on the Facebook, some of us sitting here, you told your children on Monday the 23rd not to go to school.
So we can andambe chingona tamanatina and the kaimir na lubenda ne krosa buluga tolisinga me kunra la goibuli.
The land force commander from the RFMF says it will be okay, nothing will happen. Did he say that? The acting commissioner of police, he said it will be okay, everything will be normal. Did he say that? listen to this stupid person that put a stupid message. See? It shows the level of mentality in Fiji today. That we don't listen to the mainline, that they are accountable for the news that they spread. And we listen to liars, unachievers, failures. Hallelujah. I dropped Joshua and all my children in Marish Brother in Holy Trinity and went down to Gospel High. The road was empty. Why? Because we are part of the problem in believing somebody. And it shows our mentality is so negative. Because when our mentality is negative, we listen to the fake news. Hallelujah. The news that is not even edited or proved, or they have the accountability of the rubbish they put it out there. And we are so gullible. I've been preaching 5 times a day. Kataraumana. Every 5 o'clock on Domo Ibiti. Pagatawani Mataka. On Bula FM at 4:30. Why can't people believe that? When I'm compared to that fake news with that fake person. The government is struggling because of our mentality. And new Methodist, if you have any problem, ask your Taltalangasi, because the Taltalangasi will ask me. Don't be part of the problem of the fake news. Because we were victims of fake news. So don't allow it to happen. Hallelujah. Don't believe anything that comes in the Facebook. Because those news, there's no accountability. When we put something on our television, my TV, we are accountable for the context that we put. When I'm preaching here, I'm accountable for every word that I say. Tuna ya lago tumai. Bito tumai na kaya kendra na gitawa. Supu tugo iko. Every weekend na song na itugutugu sama na mete na magawa lao mai. Waro romo sartu ya niti no kendra.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. To me, it's a signal that we have to do a lot of evangelism. That the mona of a kaiviti is very negative.
Wala no nga slebu yanai baka takila kila me lebu na viva lo tutaki malete zala tunai lenga tunai no nda baro ni baka sama.
We believe in everything that comes by without checking the truth.
Kenda na toke and the bomb out the kenga na ka kenga na roma ka ngai la mai sama dali nda ba vantira dira ta ne tu tu kenda roma.
Praise the Lord. Thank you for that Holy Spirit for allowing me to share that. Praise God. And that's why we need the Holy Spirit. Because when you read a lot of news, the Holy Spirit will tell you this is truth, this is the truth, this is the truth, or these are all lies, these are all fake. Forget this one, delete this one, delete this one. Tell the person next to you, delete everyone. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We need accountability. That when we walk with God, we need the Holy Spirit who will tell us what is real and what is not real. Hallelujah. That's why he said, go and wait, because God wants the real thing. You can come and dance around here. You can run to the altar. You can shake your body and shake your head. Hallelujah. But God said, wait, wait. When the Holy Spirit will come, then you receive power. And while you are waiting, then the truth will come. That's why from 500 drop to 400, drop to 300, drop to 200, and drop to 120. One quarter of 500 waited. three quarter they wear their three quarter and go to the street. Jesus speaks a lot of parables. He said the kingdom of God is like this. There's a sower who throw the seed, and the seed is the word of God. And the seed will fall on the wayside, and some of the seed will fall on the rocky ground. Some of the seed will fall on other thorny bushes. That's what he said.
Tisue talotaka ndonondo kakamuraki. Naone kakamuraki kina esona sorni kao na lutu na tutu ni sawa. Esona lutu na ndali bibatu esona lutu talanga na ruku ni biwa ba botona.
The Bible says, and he said, but some seed will fall on the good ground. The seed that fall on the good ground will yield more fruit. 30-fold,
60-fold,
and 100-fold. Praise the Lord. Are you still with me? Now, this four soil is the same as 500. Only one quarter is a good soil. Only one quarter wait for the Lord. We are sitting here. Only one quarter of us, really. Ask the person next to you, are you the one quarter or are you the three quarter? Hallelujah. Some of you come to church because your parents come to church. Some of us, we come to church because we belong to NCF. Some of us come to church just to mark time. Some of us come to church because we will perform our item. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Turn to the person next to you. Why are you sitting here? Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. The Bible says that when he said, go to Jerusalem on the upper room, wait for the Holy Spirit. When the Holy Spirit comes, then you receive power. So he's talking about patience.
Patience.
Hallelujah. Number two, the Bible says, let us read from the book, from verse 4 and verse 5. Acts chapter 1, 4 and 5.
Ia nisa somo ni bate keira sa baga roto merka ko ni lakotay ni Jerusalemi mero waraka nga na bos da ni yala itamana koko yendo warruba do may biyaw. Indina kando bi pedes ko choy ni nawai. Ya sambong ibi nga. Do nga ibi pedes ta kenel tam.
Hallelujah. In English.
Once when he was eating with them, he commanded them, do not leave Jerusalem until the Father sends you the gift he promised. As I told you before, John baptized with water, but in just a few days you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit.
Hallelujah. Go and wait. Number one, have patience, wait. Number two, obedience, wait. You are obeying. And these are the second condition that call the Holy Spirit to settle on you. He said, wait. Go to the upper room. I remember in John chapter 21, Jesus said, go and wait in Galilee. When Jesus came to Galilee, they were not in Galilee. They were in the lake of Galilee. Not only that, but fishing. So Jesus came to the shoreline. Hey, children. Any fish? Peter said, no. Take the net and put it on the right side. They put it on the right side. And when they pull the net, 153 fish already in the net. I don't know which one go to which. Whether the fish go into the net or the net go to the fish. One of the disciples said, it must be the Lord. Because it already happened in Gennesaret. You remember in Gennesaret? It already happened. So John said, it must be the Lord. But Peter, because of fishing and fishing and fishing, he took away all his clothes. So he was fishing naked. When you don't do what God wants you to do, you'll end up naked in trying to do what you're not supposed to do. Hallelujah. We'll be exposed. Hallelujah. Am I talking to someone? He said, wait in Galilee. Not in the lake, not fishing. Just wait for me. I will come to Galilee. Wait for me in Galilee. Praise God. You know, sometimes God is speaking to us. But we are too smart, and sometimes we have the familiar spirit. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Am I talking to somebody today? So while you're doing what you're not supposed to do, or you already left so many years ago, Peter end up naked. Hallelujah. How many Peters are sitting here today? Ask your neighbor, are you Peter? Ask the person. Are you Peter? Are you Pete? Are you Peter?
So Peter.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Jesus said, go and wait. That means there's another mission to be. They left that about 3.5 years ago. The one that happened in Gennesaret was the beginning of the ministry. The one that happened now is when he already died and rose up again. So all the miracles and all the wonders and all the teaching just come from this ear and go out this ear. How many miracles that you need for you to confirm your walk with God? How many signs that you need so you believe in God? Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Sometimes we forget very easily what God has done yesterday, or maybe last week, or maybe last month, or maybe last year. Restore our family, make our wife come back to us, man, or make a man to come back to us, wife, that you are sitting here. So many things that God already done. How many more miracles you need? So the Holy Spirit comes to you when you have the patience and when you have the obedience. Number 3, the Holy Spirit comes to you when you're in the right place. When he said the upper room, go to the upper room. When he said the wailing sea wall, go to the wailing sea wall. When he said to the cell group, go to the cell group. When he said go to the worship center, go to the worship center. God is particular with the place. When Elijah said, Mount Carmel, not any mountain, Mount Carmel. God is particular with your place. Because your place matters. When God said, the mountain of Sinai, Moses went to the Mount of Sinai.
When
God spoke to Moses in Mount Horeb and the burning bush, see, place matters to God. Curious then of for sure matters to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. So I encourage us that we are sitting here today. Make sure you go to your worship center in the midweek. The beauty is in the worship center. Because that's where we belong to, the family called NCF. Carry a stand and thanksgiving service like this is too short of a time for us to come and know one another. That's why we go to our worship center. When we finish with talk and meeting, we have a cup of tea and we talanoa. That's where we belong, to the church. You coming here because of the anointing. You coming here because of a prayer. This is not where you connect. You connect back to your worship center. If you are a church member that you only come here, you look for the worship center, please. I was sharing with the Taltala in the West, and I said, when there is a connection in the worship center, say somebody sleep or backslide, and you want to go because of the connection in the worship center and the encouragement of other members, that we become a family. It will be difficult for somebody to go back to the
world.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. This is my platform. I don't have time for everybody. That's why we have to go to our worship center.
Born on the platform, and on the Gaslevu. We tend to know the Lako and on the Vivalutra.
This is to come and pull the anointing, soak into his presence.
Hallelujah.
You get involved in your worship center. That's where you are connected with the new relatives, new friends. So when the worship center grow, the zone will be strong. When the worship center grows, there's a responsibility of the Taltala. The church becomes strong. And I, as leading, I will feel confident. Get involved in your worship center. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. That is not really a place to go and church service, that's a place of fellowship. We stand together, we put our mind together, and we see that the zone, responsibility and accountability to be done because of the strong Taltala in a worship center that makes Gasinilo too strong from the worship center. He did not pick 70. He did not pick 700. He picked only 12. Because when the 12 is connected, they can look after the 70. When the 70 is strong,
The 3,000 from one preaching from anointed Peter. Then the 70 can look after 3,000.
Na tolo tolo era toso mai na dona le buna le lumu abuno kino pita or tona le bitso bulu or tosa na kai reni rwa bina na tolo tolo.
Praise the Lord. High five to your neighbor and tell your neighbor hallelujah. I don't know that.
Abi go tosa mo si kila sa na.
You know it today.
Mo kila tio ni
know it today.
Mo kila ni kuwa.
Know it today.
Kila ni kuwa.
Don't guys your worship center. You must run to the worship center. When you have a problem, call your Taltala. Get connected to the people in the worship center. I tell you, because when we are coming together in small group, we will be big in the public places. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Okay. I'm talking about the conditions of the arrival of our friend, the Holy Spirit. Number one, patience. Number two, obedience. Number three, the importance of the place. Number four, good heart. The Bible says they were in one place, in one accord. We can be in one place, but we have a different accord. Hallelujah. The Bible says when people come together in unity, in spirit, we can sit here but not in unity. Hallelujah. We can come together physically but our heart is not connected. That's why the Bible says in Psalm 133, when the brethren come together in unity, God, a unity God, when our heart is connected. Hallelujah. In unity. They call it a double joint. Because of that conditions, you call blessings. So when you are good in the worship center, see, we have too short a time for everybody to connect and hear. This is where you come to the altar, soak into the presence, you go home. But in your worship center, we sit together. We have all the time, a cup of tea. That's where the blessings start to come. Because when brethren come together, in unity, then God command blessing. So before the Holy Spirit arrived, the Bible says in one accord, in one place. The 120, they were in one place and one accord. One yellow, not two yellows. Or three yellows. One yellow. Everybody connected to everyone. Then the Holy Spirit comes. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Am I talking to someone? Normally I share last week. Okay. You want to sell your old car and buy a new car. Or any projects. Now, you two come together and hold hands. Sonakar, you can eat together, you can walk together. Yes, sonakar, sui sui, sona sui, tukila mungun.
We can na biotini, around in sonakar na via, nakamabata, dinner around in the biotini tikonda, lori bata. Yes, sonakar, sini matata tikonda, nungun rubioka.
Hallelujah. And when you pray, it will not happen because you haven't come together in unison.
No, 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 masukina.
The Holy Spirit cannot land there because the condition is not right. Hallelujah. That's why sometimes in our church service, we just want the church service to finish because we don't feel anything. That means the church people are not connected. And then we start to sing song, praising. When you start to praise, you are coming out from your cell. That's why we need some music, melody, some singing for you to come, for the unga to come out from it. Hallelujah. Turn to your neighbor and tell your neighbor, hi, unga. Praise God. We come to church because maybe you fight in the car, or maybe you don't have a good afternoon with your wife or with your husband. You argue all the way from home until now, and when you come to church, you draw back into yourself, and normally you put your big hallelujah, your big arms, and you block the, and when we whistle, hallelujah. That's why we worship God like that. We come and praise and pray and praise and pray. And when we worship, we are near there. God is about to speak to us.
Number 5
of the condition. The Bible says, okay, let us listen to Acts chapter 2, verse 1 and verse 2.
Iyan ni sa dosar na singa ni Pentiko.
Iyo.
Er sa tikol lo mabati ko irekede na. Er ang dua tikina.
Iyo.
Sangkal lo mabati si rimay lo malang ito na rurum.
Dua.
Er bukan na tagi bukan na ruru kau kawa. Asa bawa sini tinabali tudo ko er sa tikol kina.
Continue. Tal.
Asa rere vere na kaya bukan na MPM ni buka. Bukawang santi visembaki asa tiko ando vire baka andunga.
Something very new happened. They never experienced before.
Tora kabo yado er sembera baka andoni sarina.
Nobody ran away.
Sanindo enro.
Nobody mama.
Sanindo ay bosamini mini.
Asa andunga. Kaya speaking tantiko. Kaya sa marumbera. Kaya sa tan. Casa Bosmosa, e casa Andendo. There was something new that they experienced that they never experienced with Jesus.
Dona Cabo, we have a basket of Caramanua. There is a better man than you, and I'm on a man.
So when you come to the church of Jesus Christ and new things happen, do you stand back and doubt, or you do believe?
You allow me to not teach you soon. You have a Dona Cabo, and I'm a Roma Roma Ro, Sukamuri say, or two and two.
Hallelujah. Because you will be faced with a lot of things. So nangon and dalot tigo. Niko utumali may lotok. Utumali ang mga sasarumar man tama. Utumali tuma. And a lot of people are watching from the road. It's something new. Not because of my power, the power of God that touch people's life. If Paul can fall from his horse, why? Because of the presence of God. Oh, Paul ando na tama tera. Gay sapala kira, sapala kira ano na tera. O koya batagin ano na baka tera tera sa palira. Kawa eh! Elawa. Vamos abalar lá nele. O que é que eu digo? Jesus Cristo, o que é? O que é? Não me sapala, não morri. Mas eu tenho presença. Se eu olhar a espada, eu mato. Se eu olhar a na vimos lá. Presença, bom. New. And that's why é a voz daqui aqui na Pentecostal Movement. Era tangi. Loto da baia, loto tangi tangi. Sim, loto tangi tangi. Amen. Loto da baia. Mori na loto da baia. Loto giring giring. Sim, loto giring giring. Sim, dona loto tangi tangi. Sim, dona loto giring giring. Não da ruba casa, mas não é tangiri. Não da ruba casa, mas. Amen. Sim, tu me digo na loto mole. Loto galo. Because we name things according to our judgmental states. But it's okay that I know why I'm not a guy and I don't know the woman in the valley. What is it? Don't need to do it. I don't see it. No, you know what? Don't do it. Oh, see, oh, tu adaba. Oh, see, tu adaba. Oh, see, tu adaba. Oh, see, tu adaba. Oh, see, that's how we identify people. We identify people with negative. Oh, tu atsoni, tu atsoni lava. Oh, tu atsoni olimpika. That's the fact of we are very negative. Amen. 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 Dona nungu kaza ne kwesi na korawa. Hallelujah. Tu ngame no koro. Ndo wele. Eve sombu wa itu ile Sicily ele da mai. O dina lana. Tu tu kina lana. Ke baka da no Susana. O Susana ele. We are so negative. That's why we need the word of God to change our negative to be positive. Because the blessings is drawn by the positiveness, not by negative. And that's why the blessings is running away from it, okay? Because of our negative mindset. LCF, educate your mind to be positive. So your positive mind can draw blessing, open doors, opportunity, health and wealth to look for you, overtake you and fill you. Amen. Lago maior tu na assemblies of God, mate nilo tu Pentecostal mai viti, nilo tu umbula, nilo tu songoni, luto na elo tambo, elo na tangi na giri, luto da baia, luto giri giri. Luto na luto da baia, luto tangi tangi. Ana, apaga a gani tu, apaga a lelewa. Loto da baia, loto kosa kosa. Be careful. Maybe you are speaking against the work of the Holy Spirit. So when things happen, what is I looking at the car? My taltala acting taltala ngase. Will you mind in English for me to end my Bible study today?
On the day of Pentecost.
On the day of Pentecost, the day is about to come. Sing a beago mai.
All the believers were meeting together in one place.
They were meeting together in one place. Songoni ba tenendono manua.
Suddenly there was a sound from heaven like the roaring of a mighty windstorm.
Hallelujah.
And it filled the house.
Wait. Can you read again what happened? The first thing that happened. Aye.
Suddenly.
Suddenly.
There was a sound from heaven.
There was a sound from heaven.
Like the roaring of a mighty wind.
Like a roaring mighty wind. Nobody ran away. They stand there and absorb and embrace because of faith. That's the fifth condition. A faith. You know, sometimes when you talk against the church that moved by the Holy Spirit, some of us, we disappear. Some of us, we don't want to be associated when people bicker and slander the work of the Holy Spirit.
Le weekend ni ngona e boss take kina na lotu na dala ni lotamu e ba kanda rere nga isu ke muri.
None of these people back away or back down or go through the door. They stand there and embrace the rushing mighty wind.
Rotoke na mora tuma ndoa, sani ndoa ro, sani ndoa suka. Era ba bina bina ataka na vanga ni alotambu.
Hallelujah. And the mighty wind of God is still moving today.
Ya na vanga ni alotambu ya si tostuma ni kwa.
When the sudden things come to your life, mighty winds. We are in Lotoka. Zones are increased by 10, 20, 30. Some increased by 50 new members. They are coming in. There's a sound of a rushing mighty wind. And I believe the zone in Suba from Serua region right up to Koribi and Nabilebu. There are new people coming. There's a rushing of a mighty wind. Embrace it. Maita. Taltala, go down again. The second thing.
And it filled the house where they were sitting. Then what looked like flames or tongues of fire appeared.
And there was a tongue of fire. It appears. It's not fire. It appears. It appears like a tongue of fire. And every one of them has it.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. You know, sometimes strange things happen. You go to my duty, you go back. Soak into his presence. Because when you walk with God, strange things happen to you all the time. He is God. Protegar. We'll continue next week. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. New Kadivi meu telai, young Andreva meu bouquet. Hallelujah. Let us rise to our feet as we sing along. If you want to raise your hand. Raise your hands. Soak into his presence.
Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Sin dong mo mula dam na kalu na kung sa talibig kami ni de na lang lang may nomunitigo na si Sunny Bangamu.